I am so excited about the Year of the Nurse. 2020 is such a great opportunity for us to really share with the world what nursing is all about.
I think having 2020 as the Year of the Nurse really brings home how important it is to spotlight our profession, not only internationally, but on every level. The Year of the Nurse also gives us an opportunity to expand on nursing as a profession for men and women. It's not only a female's profession anymore. And whatever we can do to share that passion that we have, that we take care of our patients every day in our communities, really highlights what we do as nurses. For AORN and being a perioperative nurse, the Year of the Nurse isn't just one celebration in November. It's throughout the entire year. And it's just an exciting way to be able to really highlight what we do every single day, one patient at a time, one family at a time.
It's very exciting. The Year of the Nurse, designated by the World Health Organization, is a fantastic recognition of the contribution that nurses make to healthcare across the globe. When I think about this, I am amazed, first of all, that we haven't done this before, but second of all, hopeful that this really brings nursing as a profession to the center of the table as we talk about what healthcare is for the populations across the world. You know, when I think of not just from a perioperative standpoint, we're caring for patients every day in operating rooms, but public health settings, all kinds of arrangements where patients are coming to receive care, to receive their health, to really focus on what they need to live long lives and contribute to society. Nursing is really at the center of what that is and what it, how we're able to help people with that.
When you think about the impact that nurses have internationally, and it's not just periop, it's every facet of healthcare. I think back when I was a student and my first exposure to perioperative nursing, I fell in love. And every time there was an opportunity, if I had a classmate who didn't want to go, I was the one raising my hand saying, I'll go to the OR. And having that passion and being able to share that with students and everyone is really exciting.
I agree. I can remember that as well. And nursing, not having many opportunities to go into the operating room. And when I finally got the opportunity to be trained and work there, it was the most exciting day for me. Starting as a nurse in the operating room and taking care of patients each day, you know, one patient at a time, and seeing how we can impact patients and particularly their families. You know, we talk about a lot about patient care, but the reality is I learned very quickly that I was also caring for the families that were waiting for news about what was happening with their loved ones. And so it's an opportunity in perioperative nursing to really care for the whole family.
And I think that's evolved over the years because now we find ambulatory surgery such an important part of the perioperative role and needing to educate patients because they're going to go home with their loved ones. And during that initial phase, when several years ago they were in the hospital for a week, and now they're going home that day. So the engagement with the family and the continuum of care is so important for perioperative nursing. And I think over the years, we have seen it evolve. And now I think we're moving into a whole new era. What are your thoughts about that?
Well, when I think of how much technology itself has changed, you know, patients have changed, we as a society have changed, but technology has made exponential differences in the care of patients. Mm-hmm. We can care for patients so much quicker than we used to post-operatively. As you said, moving things from an inpatient setting to an outpatient setting, an ambulatory. But there, that brings with it an awful lot of preparation that we need to do for patients. It's unbelievable. When I think of what our perioperative nurses are managing on any day, in any case, the amount of technology, not just from the care technology touching patients as well as the information systems that they engage with. But the stakes are very high in the operating room. And that is a setting that we need nurses that are really charged by the intensity. You know, I tell people all the time, there's no such thing as a minor procedure. And that's the truth. It's very small cases still require tremendous amounts of expertise and skill.
I agree wholeheartedly. When I started my practice, laparoscopic surgery was new. And we thought that was intimidating. And now we have our hybrid ORs and robotics. And it's just a phenomenal amount of technology. And just like you said, Dave, with the, you know, electronic health record, how informatics and that specialty for nurses has exploded as well.
You both bring up a really good point, which is the high touch, but high tech. The operating room does represent that. Perioperative nurses are high tech. No question about that. But it is the touch that is the most vulnerable time of the patient's experience is in surgery when they are frequently anesthetized. They can't say, my arm is under me.
Right.
I'm losing some nerves. It's just such a different way of caring for the patient because they can't give input into it.
So I think with 2020 being the year of the nurse, it really gives us an opportunity as a profession to heighten the community's awareness that we live in. Our politicians getting behind everyone to really pass and forward the agenda. I mean, after all, we've been the most trusted profession for so many years that we need to really expand on that and be able to have the ability to show everyone what nurses do, especially behind that red line or behind that mask.
Well, and I've thought about why nurses are the most trusted profession. And I do absolutely believe it is about the connection that nurses are able to make with patients and their families. And to be able to develop that trust so quickly, we don't have a lot of time with patients, particularly in the perioperative setting. And it's such a high skill to be able to establish that trust so quickly with your patients, to know from a family standpoint that you are handing over care of your loved one to someone else. They only do that with nurses. And I think that really is testimony to how trusted nurses are. And this year of the nurse will really help us be able to celebrate that.
So I think this gives us a great opportunity to expand on mentoring. We talk about mentoring in nursing all the time, and we really have to, as leaders, take those new to the profession by the hand and show them what it can be for them in the future. I think we have an extreme opportunity with the year of the nurse and just the messaging around it on how we can really impact our profession. We're going to have a tremendous shortage, and we need to reach out to the junior highs and the high schools and get them involved and look at nursing as a career. And that's part of the mentorship for the year of the nurse.
David, what about you? What do you think? You're going to be president in the year of the nurse.
Yes.
2020.
It's very exciting. I think as I look at nursing, we have become very specialized, as our physician colleagues have. And one of the things that we really need to be focused on is how we are collaborating across the profession, all of our specialties working together. The truth of the matter is that our patients experience us across the continuum, and we have not connected well across the continuum among nurses. And so this is an opportunity for us to really collaborate together on care from a patient-focused standpoint. How they experience us from the clinics into the operating rooms, into the PACUs, into the inpatient units and back. And so how are we really connecting that care for a patient? We need to think differently about how we are developing our evidence base so that we are ensuring that continuum is a part of what we are evaluating, not our subspecialty segment alone. Mm-hmm. It needs to be the whole patient continuum. So I think this is a year that will allow us a great celebration to kick off lots of innovation for what nursing practice might be in the future, for coordination of care from a patient-focused standpoint, what they need across the continuum. So I'm very excited about what this means for nursing.
That's great. You know, and I think one of the things I hope that all of our members and non-members understand is how important it is to engage, to engage every day in the profession and in nursing. Only then can we continue to move the stakes forward and really demonstrate what it is that we do that is so unique for patients. So, Missy, how do you see perioperative nursing changing over the next 10 years?
Oh, my goodness. When I think about the last 10 years and how much has changed, I think we're going to see far more in our outpatient settings. Patients want to be home, and that's the safest place sometimes for them to be. So we're having these complex procedures that we're going to be moving out to the ambulatory surgery centers, and those nurses need to have the resources that they need to be prepared for that change.
We now are caring for patients that 10 years ago would have never even been candidates to receive
Absolutely.
Care. And what we're seeing now is that is beginning to shift into not just occurring in an inpatient setting, but now in an outpatient setting. And so I do think that one of the advances for perioperative nursing is remarkably our connection to home care nurses may be developing in the next 10 years. We're going to see more and more patients that are on life support type technology at home. And so the transfer of what we have done in a procedural setting to a patient at home with their family caregivers as well as home health caregivers will be vital in what it means for the health of our nation. So it'll be very different.
Mm-hmm. I also see for the inpatient nurses a little bit different perspective. The patients are going to be sicker. They're going to have coexisting morbidities and existing disease processes that are going to be very difficult for us to manage. So I think the skill level is going to be higher for the inpatients in a very different way than what it is now. I think also collaboration with the anesthesiologist, with the surgeon, potentially even as a team to discuss patients prior to deciding whether or not that surgery will be performed, because that assessment is going to be so important to make sure that we're not taking patients to surgery that are vulnerable and the outcome less desirable. I also think that nursing education is going to change. I think that's where we're going to see a big shift. I believe perioperative nursing will be back in the curriculum as at least an elective in most schools of nursing because it fits with the CUSIN so clearly. The quality, safety, and nursing education, it just fits there. That's what it's all about. So I think education is going to shift also.
And I actually started my nursing career as a med-surg nurse before I went to the OR. So I had that perspective from, you know, the patients pre and post, and then saw what they actually went through, you know, intra-op, and had a completely different perspective. So I think that education and that team coordination between all areas across the continuum is going to be critical in the future.
I hope that you are correct about the change in nursing education, because as I think about what nurses on inpatient units need to do to take care of our patients postoperatively, there's so much knowledge that they need about positioning, about how we are supporting the hemodynamics for these patients that are somewhat unrelated to the surgical incision or procedure that they had. But they impact the care tremendously. And so this is what I term as what every nurse needs to know about the operating room.
Right.
And those are the things that make a big impact to patient care after surgery.
For many years, nursing has really taken a backseat in healthcare. And this gives us an opportunity to really show with a great deal of pride and caring how nursing makes a difference every day in every encounter that we have with patients. It's a great opportunity for AORN to continue to support perioperative nurses in their setting, wherever that is. And we believe so strongly in lifelong learning. We have so many opportunities for the nurses to participate in lifelong learning and to look at their careers in nursing. AORN is there for the perioperative nurses all across the world. We have an opportunity to engage in many international as well as national events, and to tell people and to share with our colleagues what it is that we do behind those doors. Not many people know, and we are an important part of the surgical patient's experience. I've often heard that the anesthesiologists take care of the heart and the lungs, the surgeon does the surgery, but it's the perioperative nurse that takes care of the whole patient. It's holistic nursing care. That's what perioperative nursing is. Dave and Missy, I'm so excited about the opportunity we had to visit with it about the Year of the Nurse and to really talk about how we're going to celebrate it. It is an important year, and thank you so much for taking time to share your thoughts.
We're just glad to be here.